Hello. This is a completely unrehearsed presentation of two incredible cars. They deserve much more attention, especially in terms of being washed and detailed. I have become so overwhelmed in so many things that I'm just only able to make sure that they're properly maintained, everything up to date, and of course protected from the sun and water. There's so much to tell that I really am at a loss for words right now. I'm going to write things on this channel. I'm going to show everything. You can see I'm not trying to hide any flaws. Those little specks on the fender, that's grass from the weed eater. These polish up incredibly well, and don't even think that water's from that car under there. And as the little note in the beginning of this film stated, one of these has the amazing airbag system, or ACRS. A lot of people don't know about it. Maybe a lot more don't care, but it's really some lesson in history on top of just something that would protect you in using it. I also have all complete replacement components if the car was ever damaged. That ACR system proved to be as reliable as the modern day system. This one has the electric seat back release, which a lot of people like. You can everything is in proper order. This car needs some fabric, which is available. It's all original. The carpets are new. There's no cracking on the dashboard or door panels. What next? And open up. The clocks keep perfect time. Original mat. It has the locking gas cap, which is a clever deal. You may notice the different bumperettes on this 74 versus that. Only four states had these long ones, and obviously that's a dealer installed hitch that was only used by me for to haul a jet ski once. But that's the type of hitch, for those of you who know, that doesn't put a load on the car, and therefore it's not like the Reese trailer hitches, which would put extra wear on the engine. So I didn't have time to do the... Oh, I also have the original Firestone spares. Both of these cars have spares matched to the current tires. The original Firestone, new Firestone tires for both cars are in storage. I hope I don't run out of it. I can't believe how quickly... Both of them have all the same equipment except for the airbag system, and this one doesn't have the electric seat back release. And you see the different shoulder belts. The airbag car did not have shoulder belts. The clocks are not set to the proper time right now because I've had them disconnected. They draw on the battery. And jacks have never been used. A lot of polishing could take place. Armor all on the original vinyl top. And it's just, for somebody that knows what this car is, it's an incredible car. And it's got the charcoal-activated filtered incoming air temp-matic system, AM/FM8 track. Both have the visor mirrors on them. And these are what was considered a completely and fully loaded car. Now I'm going to stop. And this one has a perfect condition fabric. Now the lighting on these digital cameras can mislead you to think that there's something wrong with the fabric, but it looks beautiful black corduroy. Very impressive to anybody that can appreciate the styles of the great cars of the 70s. I sure wish I was in 1974 right now with this. This was a car that both Muhammad Ali and Hugh Hefner had 74 Toronados for a bit. Sure, they had all sorts of cars, but it's interesting to me that they also had these 74 Toronados. Got the thermometer from the factory option, and again, this airbag system, I've got all the films on it that show it. It actually has a dual-stage airbag system for different levels of crash, like the modern. It's amazing that it's controlled by modern-day integrated circuit chips, and there's airbags for all three front passengers, which obviously the armrests go up, and now we're going to look at the engine. Now you can see the AC compressor's running. I think it may have a slight overcharge with the oil, but I have to confirm that. After 3 years, it needed a little Freon, and I used my years of experience instead of a high pressure gauge, which I will correct. This is something for you experts. You see this item? There's a big history on that. That's something that actually electrostatically cleans the air. Very unusual. I've never seen one. I've actually got to speak to the original owner to get more history or research. Now, you can see a little bit of a shake because this car has not been driven. They've been sitting. They need a fan belt. I've got the little labels that go there for you serious buffs. And when it's driven, it smooths out. The cylinders are all perfect. The engine was not rebuilt. It was taken out to put oil seals, and it was colored the exact same color it was originally. I mean, the exact same color. And there are even everything I do to it has its Delco, even the battery, oil filter, and now we go to this one, which is original 36,000 miles. By the way, the one you just saw was 65,000 miles original. Any expert can verify that. And this is 35,000 miles, and it too, it has perfect operating AC. I don't like that somebody, a mechanic, got away with this, because I would make this like the other one, but a lot of people don't care. That's an inexpensive hose that you can find new old stock. I just like every little detail to be exactly as it was in 1974 or 5, which has always been my goal. And for me to point something out like that, I hope lets you know that I'm not trying to hide anything. Underneath the car, I'll get some. Let me get a little sound here. The two, they've got different mufflers on them, but they were supposed to be factory mufflers, and they sound the same. Well, actually, I take that back. Those are the, I don't know where I just left off. I lost myself, and I don't know what I've explained, but this one needs a fan belt. It's painted to the exact original color only because the oil seals were changed on the oil pan. I'm running out of time on this silly little camera. And this one's original 36,000 miles and never been touched, obviously, cosmetically. Whereas this one, you can see, I even have the little sticker that goes there with the code for you buffs. Oh boy, I hope I didn't already say that. But what else? I've got a 3 minutes. AC's working perfect. You can see the compressors. This one's 65,000 original. So I just had to put a quick charge on this battery. Those are, by accident, the 73 exhaust pipes, which are sticking out about an inch too far. Just give you an example how I know every little detail about what these cars should be. And there's so much to tell. I always forget if I've pressed the record button or not. I don't know if the lighting's enough to see, but the frames still have their black paint on. There's no rust underneath. I'll have to, you can stop this and pause it. The tires are all excellent. I know this is not the right way to do it, but I really don't have time. The drive axle boots are perfect. The front air dam is there. For those experts, it has the torsional dampers that are often not reinstalled on the passenger drive axle. And then this probably doesn't look good in a way to show it. But there's no rust, there's nothing unusual. And here's the last view. Hope a thief doesn't look up my tag numbers, huh? They're watched over and protected. And they were garaged up until recently. And now they're kept under water-resistant blankets for the windows and everything, and got quality car covers for rain. And they're watched over and will be until they're sold. I've just found myself, as you may have a clue by the way I speak and the haphazard way I've gone about this, that I am overwhelmed with projects now. And not being able to keep these in a garage, they are going. So hopefully somebody in the world recognizes how incredible these are and will offer me a fair price. Obviously, you have a clue by now. I have a lot in them. But I will respect the economy, and for somebody that can appreciate what they are, I will definitely work with you. Any questions? And I can give you every... See, I know this. That fabric, exact fabric, it's $80 a yard. And the back seats are fine. And but everything else is flawless. And then if you notice, there was no shoulder belts in the airbag car. And then of course this one's perfect. The coloring is off because of the digital camera. Original comfort clips you don't see too often. That beautiful three-spoke steering wheel that you rarely see on these, with the beautiful wood. Perfect door panels, which are usually cracked. 8-track works perfect. And I probably screwed this up presentation, but I'm not hiding anything, and somebody's going to be lucky to have an incredible something I bet you'll never find anywhere else on the planet. These two triple black, they'd be great for a museum to teach history on the airbag system. That's a big government no-no, what took place, big business, for those of you who like cover-up stories. And what else? But they're just fun to drive. They drive wonderful, and they have the prestige of Rolls-Royce. I could have bought two Rolls-Royces.